Hi, I am author Liz Tolsma, and I am super excited because it is release week for Neil Tolsma's new book, Love Matters. And just a disclaimer, he is my dad, so it's weird for me to call him Neil, but I'm excited to have him with me here today. He's going to be doing this for the next 5 days, and we're just going to talk a little bit about the book. So, hi, Dad. Hi, Neil.
Good morning.
Like I said, we've been anticipating the release of Love Matters for quite some time now, so it must be a very exciting week for you.
It certainly is.
Why don't you tell the audience a little bit about why you wrote the book Love Matters?
I'm a retired pastor, and over the 40 years that I served as a pastor, I did quite a bit of counseling. And in my times of counseling, I discovered, especially I remember one counseling session in which it struck me that the people I was counseling did not know what love is. And of course, love can be a very important part of counseling. For instance, if I'm counseling a couple getting ready to get married or who are having problems in marriage and other situations too, that love is of prime importance, just as love is of prime importance in life and in our faith. If you read the Bible, you soon discover the centrality of love in scriptures. And so when I thought of that, that people don't know what love is, I needed to give them a good description and definition of love. And that prompted me to begin writing about love. And finally, I'm getting to this second book called Love Matters. In my earlier book, I talked about the love that God has for us. The basic definition that I'm working with, which I think is the best definition of love, is a biblical definition or description of love. God is love. And in order to know what love is, you have to begin by knowing God. Now, in Love Matters, I take it a step farther. And that is that we're dealing with our love for God and for other people in Love Matters. What does it mean to love a person? What does it mean to love other people? Now, in discovering that people did not know what love is, I would talk to them about love, and I would get the description or the idea from these people that they thought love was some kind of sentimentalism. They didn't demand much of commitment, or they would think of romance. That's a prime idea of love today, the idea of romance. Or I talked to a friend about the same time I began writing, and I said, I'm writing a book about love. And he said, oh, it must be a book about sex. Well, that's not what love is. Love is so much more than that. And so in my books, I wanted to bring across the idea of what love is according to the Bible, what love is according to God. So we get to know the love of God. And then in order to really know the love of God, we need to begin to practice that love, to put it into the center of our lives and to make it an life experience. And you need to do that in how you treat people, especially how you treat your spouse, how you treat your parents, how you treat your children, your neighbor, your coworkers. And that's what we deal with in Love Matters. We talk about our love, about God's love for us, and then about our love for God as we begin the book. And then in further chapters, we deal with how to get to experience that kind of love in our lives so that we can begin to practice it. And then how we are to love one another in marriage and in the home and on the job and in church with other people, and how even the church is to practice love on the international scale with missions or other type of agencies for relief of the people that might need our help around the world. So that's what I'm basically trying to accomplish in this book, so that people can begin to see what love is all about and how they can begin to make it a vital part of their lives.
So it's a really important book for, like you said, our relationship to God and our relationship to other people. It touches every part of our lives and every one of the dealings that we have throughout our day and throughout the week. So Love Matters is a very important book. And the rest of the week, we're going to be talking about why it matters and more about the book and his purpose in writing it. So I hope that you will join us each day as we build on what Neil has just said and some of the important matters that he has brought up, and that you will also go out and get a copy of Love Matters. It is available on Amazon. It's, now I'm biased, but it is very conversational in its tone. It's written not for theologians, but for lay people like you and I. So it's very easy to understand. It's perfect for private devotions or couple devotions or Sunday school groups, small groups, or just to sit and read. It's a very good all-around guide, whatever purpose you want to use it for. So thank you, Neil. Thank you, Dad, for joining us today. And we will be back tomorrow then with another short little video talking about Love Matters.
Thank you.